Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to our studio. I believe this studio is going to help you in understanding one of the most crucial topic in physics, which is electricity. Okay, so without wasting much of our time, let's get into the main issue of our tutorial. And today's topic is electricity. As you know, this is a topic that is very cardinal, and it comes every year in physics final exam, especially both in science paper 1 and in science physics paper 2. So therefore, we are going to define what is electricity. We are going also to define, we are going also to understand what are some of the units that are used to measure currents, and also the units for measuring charges. From there, we move on to resistance, voltage, we define them, both the definition and the units. Also, connection of resistance. As you know, electricity actually is based on the concept of understanding what are resistors and how do we connect them so that we can calculate how much current is passing as well as how much voltage is flowing. So we'll talk about series connection as well as parallel connection. And then finally, we'll end the tutorial with some of the examples from the discussion above. So as you can see from that side, we've got the example. So the first example will come from the top questions, and then we've got two examples coming from the top, and then down here we also have an example which will help us to understand the concept that we are going to learn under connection of resistance. Okay. So, without wasting much of our time, we are going to start by defining what is electricity. So, this is each one of us should be able to understand what is electricity. Now, electricity is simply the flow of electric current. Now, what we mean by the flow of electric current, we mean that electricity is the flow of current. But again, we need also to understand that what is current, and how do we just understand what we just mean by current. So this is what we are going to define. So now, current, or rather electric current, so I'll start by making it simple. Current is to start by giving the formula. First of all, current equals to the quantity of charges per unit time. Okay, so in physics you have to be very systematic in our definitions by simplifying your life. So all you have to do is, first of all, you write down the formula. Then once you write down the formula, then from here you can define what is current. So from there we can say current is the amount of charges that passes a point per unit time. So we are saying that current is just the amount of electric charges that passes a point per unit time. Okay, so, and this is the formula for current. Therefore, I believe each one of us should be able to understand and just know that this is the formula for calculating the current. So now, what are some of the units of currents as well as for charges? Now we start with charges. Okay, so as you all know from the basic concept of chemistry, we understand that there are two types of charges. You have positive and negative charges. So you have positive and negative. Therefore, charges in this case, when you talk about electric current, will be simply referring to the electrons which are negatively charged. So we need to understand to say, when you are talking about charges, we have to understand that there are two types, the positive charge and the negative charge. So the negative charge are our main concern, and these negative charges are the electrons. Therefore, in that case, when you talk about charges passing through a point, we are talking about electrons flowing in a wire or a conductor, which we all know, like the cable for Zesco and all these electrical wires that we see in our homes. Okay, so now from there, we understand that current is the amount of charges that flows, that passes a point per unit time. And then we understand that charges, these are just the electrons that we'll be dealing with. Now, what are the units of charges and currents? So, current is measured in amps. Okay, so current is measured in amps. What is the charges? The charges is measured in coulombs, symbolized by capital C, coulombs. Now the current has got, we'll be using a symbol for current of I. So I will be representing current. Okay, so now we have to understand that current is measured in amps and charges is measured in coulombs. And then the symbols that we'll be using for charge is C, the symbol for current is I. So I hope you understand the units as well as the definition of current. Now we are moving on to resistance as well as voltage. Okay, so resistance. So resistance is the opposition to the flow of current. Okay, so resistance is the opposition to the flow of current, meaning that whenever current flows into the resistor, we expect the resistance to oppose the motion of that current. So now, one of the major concepts that we need to understand is that when you have more resistance, then less current flows. Okay, so this is a good concept to understand, because in most of the exam papers they will ask you to say which in which kind of a resistor or which resistor will expect more current or less current. Then the reason is simple, because if you have more resistance opposing the flow of current, then we're expecting just a few current to be flowing, because the opposition is too big. Okay, so that is the definition. And then the units. So resistance is measured in ohms,
which is symbolized by that symbol. So don't forget, this is the symbol for resistance, and then this is the units. Therefore, what about voltage? Okay, so voltage is the most trick thing that you need to understand. When you're talking about voltage, we are going to explain some of the concepts behind voltage. So I've got two types of voltage. The first one is EMF, which is just electromotive force. Okay, so the first type of voltage that you need to understand is electromotive force, which is just abbreviated as EMF, which is equal to that electromotive force. Then the last one is PD. Now PD stands for potential difference. Now, if you want just to understand the whole topic of electricity, is that this is the point where you need to focus so much, because people get confused what we mean by electromotive force and PD. Electromotive force, actually, this is the force which actually ensures that when you are talking about the electrons in the battery, now these are moving. This is the battery. So the concept in understanding electromotive force is that when the circuit is complete, you expect the electron to start moving within the battery. So the amount of energy or the amount of voltage that causes the electron to start moving within the voltage, which is within the battery, is what is referred to electromotive force. So means that the energy which is delivered to each unit of the charge, to each charge within the battery, is also called the energy transferred. What we mean is that the electrons, they receive the energy from the battery and then they start moving. So because they have to be in motion, you need to understand that any work done within the electrons is what is actually referred to amount of energy being delivered to the electrons. Meaning that if you are told to say, can you find the amount of energy that is being delivered to each coulomb of the electron or charge, you don't even have to use the formula. Because as long as the battery is 12 volts, it simply means that 12 joules of energy is being delivered to each coulomb of charge when the electrons start moving. So that is the point you need to understand. Now, coming to potential difference is one of the voltage, type of the voltage, apart from the electromotive force. So this is the voltage. When now the electrons start moving outside the battery to a circuit component, e.g. bulb. Bulb. These charges that you have seen now in the battery, they will start moving from the battery, now going to the circuit component, which you have just said about. Therefore, there will be a difference, or rather the drop down in the voltage. Means that Since this bulb has got some resistance. Now, this resistance is what is opposing some of the current to the bulb. And this is the reason why we expect even some of the bulb that we see around us to be producing energy, such as heat energy, as well as light energy. Okay, so we need to understand the difference. Therefore, we are going to use this concept in the upcoming tutorials. Otherwise, first of all, you just need to understand the two types of voltage, and then in our next tutorial, we'll be able now to give examples concerning the types of tutorial. Okay, so now let me move on to the last part of the content, which you are saying that connection. Connection of resistors. Okay, so now we have to understand to say, whenever you are given a question, you expect some resistance to be connected either in series or in parallel. So the resistors, we mentioned to say we have got two types of connection. So we have the series. Now, what are some of the conditions in series? So number one is that voltage is different. Number two, current is the same. So once you understand what we mean by these conditions, you must be able to understand that when you find the question that you are trying to solve, you should first of all identify the type of connection in that circuit. So, are the resistors connected in series? Are the resistors connected in parallel? Now, if you are connected in series, then the condition that you need to know is that, first of all, the voltage at each resistor will be different, and then the current at each resistor will be the same. So once we understand this concept, then any question, we can solve any kind of equation that is attached to resistors connected in series. So therefore, these are the conditions that you need to understand. Don't forget, the voltage is different when you're dealing with resistors connected in series. The current will be the same throughout the circuit. When you calculate the total current, that is the same current at each different resistors. So meaning that once you calculate the total current, that is the current passing through each resistor. Now, the last type of connection is the parallel connection. Okay, so parallel you need also to understand what are the conditions that are attached. So in parallel connection, the first condition is that, in fact, the conditions that should be satisfied when you're dealing with parallel resistors is that they are the opposite of resistors connected in series. So voltage, or rather the PD, or just simply voltage, is the same, yeah. And then the current which will be equals to different. So when you just check out these conditions, they are the opposite of the conditions in series connection. So
We said in series, the current is the same, the voltage is different. In parallel, the voltage is the same, the current is different. Okay, now after learning about all these that we have talked about, let's now see how we can apply them just in, and be able to understand how you can tackle any question concerning what we just talked about. So we start with our first example, which is attached to the first content. Okay, so now I hope you can see the question. The first question is saying, find the size of the current flowing through a wire when 0.8 coulomb of charge passes a point in the wire in 2 seconds. Okay, so this is a simple question. As long as we understand the formula for calculating current, where when you are given the time as well as the charges. So before you start answering any question, in science you need to have your data. You need to get the information from the question. So our current, they are saying is find the size of the current. So we don't have this the current, so we put a question mark. We also understand that we have the quantity of charge, which is 0.8 coulomb. 0.8 coulombs. And we also have time, which is Z2, that is 2 seconds. Okay. Now, once you get that information, all you need now is the formula which answers how much is current flowing. So therefore, current equals to Q, which is the quantity of charge over time. Then from there, we can just get how much is the charges, 0.8. How much is the time, 2 seconds. Then when we divide, we are going to get 0.4 amps. Or 0.4A. Okay, so this is how simple it is for us to just calculate how much current is flowing. So this is the answer for example number one. That is number one. Now number two, the question says the self-starter of a motor car uses a current of 20 amps for 10 seconds, what quantity of electricity flows through the starter? So therefore, you do the same again. You get the information from there. So you have been told that the current is 20 amps, the quantity of charge is how much you are looking for, and the time is 10 seconds. So from there again, we are going to use this same formula to find the quantity of charge. So the formula is I equals to Q over T. And then since you are looking for I, we just make Q the subject of the formula. So you cross multiply. So you have 1 times Q, you get Q. I times T, you get IT. Therefore, the current is 10, as well as the time is the current is 20, the time is 10, so therefore you have 30 coulombs. Okay, so these are the worked examples under the first content that we talked about, the current, the charges, as well as the time takes for a current to flow in a wire. So I hope you'll be able to understand when you try to go through. Now let's go to the last example, which we are going to solve. Or now we can just understand the connection of resistors. Okay, So without wasting much of our time, we'll just draw a circuit. Okay. So our first is 2, followed by 4, followed by 6, and then let's have the voltage attached there. So that is a positive, that is a negative, the current moves in that direction. So now let's read the question. The question is saying, resistors of 2, 4 and 6 ohms have got connected to a 24 volts battery across them. First question is, find the total resistance, the current flowing, the voltage across each resistor. Okay, so the first thing that we are going to do is, how do we find the total resistance in series connection? So we are going to say this is 24 volts. We are going to say we have total resistance equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3, meaning that R1 is for the first resistor, R2 is for the second, R3 is for the third. So if you had 4, you can also just include plus 4 plus R4, but in that case, that is not the case, so we just end on R3. Therefore, we just say 2 plus 4 plus 6. This is going to be 6 plus 6. This is going to be 12 ohms. Okay, so we have answered A. Let's move on to B. Now, B, the question is saying the current flowing. In short, they are asking us to find the total current that is flowing. Therefore, we are going to use ohms law, which is equal to resistance equals to voltage over current. So we are going to make high the subject, which is going to be current equals to voltage over resistance. Remember, this is our total voltage, this is our total current, and we are looking for the total current. So the T in the formula stands for total. So therefore, we have 24 divided by 12. So when you do that, you get 2 amps. So that is our answer on B. So this is the total current that is flowing. You can just indicate that flowing I coming is 2 amps. Yeah. So now the last question is saying, can we find the voltage across each resistor? Okay. Okay, so for us to find the voltage across each resistor, the main thing that we need to understand is when we add voltage 1 plus voltage 2 plus voltage 3, the sum of these voltages must give us the total voltage which have been given in the question. So therefore, the first thing that we need to understand is, we are going to say voltage 1, meaning voltage at resistor 1, equals to let me just say this plus that. So equals to total current multiplied by the resistor 1 at that resistor given. So therefore, you are going to have our total current is 2 multiplied by resistor there, it is 2. So voltage at resistor 1 is equal to 4. Then V2 equals to current total multiplied by resistor 2. This is going to be 4 times 2, or the other way around, 2 times 4, or you have 60 volts. votes. So at resistor 2 we have 6 volts. Finally, voltage 3 equals to current 2 times resistor 3. Now this is going to give you a total current is 2, resistor 3 is 6, so you get 12 volts. Now to prove that you have gotten everything correct, you just need to add all the three voltages and then you get back to 24. So you are going to say prove total voltage equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So our voltage 1 is 4, our voltage 2 is 6, our voltage 3 is 12. So 4 plus 6 is 10. 10 plus 12. What mistake have I made? We have 2 times 2, 24. Must give me 24. Okay, there is something, there is an error. Where is an error? Oh, 6, 12, voltage 2 is 8. Okay, we made an error. Okay, so now voltage 1 equals to 4, voltage 2 equals to 8, sorry, there was an error, and then the last voltage is called 8, we get 12 plus 12, and then we get 24 volts, and this is equal to total volt. Okay guys, so that was our first series under the topic electricity. I hope you have gotten something, and I hope you are going to benefit a lot before you just write your final exam in physics. All you have to do is just take time and then go through. And if you want to learn more of my tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you can follow them from one tutorial to the next tutorial. I'll see you next time.